let's talk about some of the different types of thermometers that you may find in your hardware stores or your local discount stores or any of the kitchen stores. This one is called a thermocouple. This is probably a high-end type thermometer, and you may not find these in stores. If you do, they're probably smaller than this. The distinguishing factor about these is that the probe is very thin and very small. These are pretty sophisticated type thermometers, and they will be a little more expensive. So for typical kitchen use, this may not be a practical choice for a kitchen. The thermocouple can read temperatures pretty rapidly. These types of thermometers can be calibrated so that you can make sure they're reading properly. And then this is a wire that goes to the measuring device to read the temperature. These are not to be used inside the oven, so you just do a temperature at when you open up the door and stick the thermometer probe in to their product. So you don't leave these in the oven the whole cooking time. Another type of thermometer is called a thermistor. This is like a digital thermometer. It's usually handheld, pretty simple, pretty easy to use and easy to read. There are different styles of these types of thermometers that are out there. This one happens to be more of a rectangle size. You can also find them in a round dial type shape. This one has a handy case for it, so you just pull the case off like that and stick the thermometer into the product. These types of thermometers have the temperature reading point at the tip of the probe. So you want to try to make sure that you insert the thermometer into the center of the food. This is called a semiconductor that's in the tip of the probe. You do not want to leave this in the oven for the whole cooking time because this is plastic and it will melt. So that's, again, this is just a, towards the end of cooking process, put the thermometer into the center of the product to get an accurate reading. Not all models of these types of thermometers can be calibrated. And then this also has a on and off switch right here. And you can go back and forth between Celsius and Fahrenheit if you so choose. Once the product that you're cooking is looking like it's done and you've taken a temperature and you find out that really it's not at the appropriate temperature that it should be, take it out, let the product cook a little longer. You want to wash your thermometer off in between, or you could even take a sanitizing wipe and wipe off the thermometer just to clean it, and that way you don't cross-contaminate anything because there may be bacteria that's not killed yet from the first time that you check the temperature. So always wash it. Just simply run it under some soap and water and wash it off, and then take your temperature again. So that's a good practice to remember.
Production support for this video has been provided by Hy-Vee. For more information, visit the K-State Research and Extension website at www.ksre.ksu.edu.